Welcome back to the workshop. What do you see in front of you? You see a 3-in-1 kit. And when I say 3-in-1 kit, it doesn't mean you can build one kit three ways. It means we have 1, 2, 3 entire kits. We have the Piranha Drag Car, the Piranha Spy Car, or you can make it as a spy car, and the trailer. All in 1/25th scale. Let's take a look at everything in the box. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this as a two-part video, okay? In the first part, we're going to go ahead and build the tow car, or as some of you know it, the spy car from old days. We're going to go ahead and build the tow vehicle. So let's get all the parts out here for the tow vehicle. In the second part, we're going to go ahead and we're going to build the trailer and the dragster, and then we'll show them all off together. But you can see the parts on here for the tow car. We got our two-piece body. Very nicely molded. This has been re-released in a few different versions, most recently as that cool spy car. It looks very neat. I've never built it myself, so we'll get some learning experience in with this. It's got gull wing doors that actually open. It's got the cool engine there. Looks like a twin turbo from what I was looking at in the directions. We've got our hood there with great underhood detail. We've got body moldings. We've got bucket seats. So if you've never built the kit, it's new for you, it's new for me. That's why we're going to do it. And because it's three kits, we don't want to do a two-hour-long video here. We're just going to do it in sections. We're going to do certain parts in there, and we're going to look at the chrome pieces. Lots of chrome on there with those nice wheels. And then we've got the option of clear glass, yellow-tinted glass, and we've got our red taillights. Now, one cool feature about this kit is we've got four tires that are red line on one side and beautiful Goodyear Speedway tires on the other side with the blue line in a very nice tread pattern. Now, what else is also going to be in the box? Of course, you're going to get two other kits, the dragster and the trailer, but we'll go over those in part two and let you see that. One of the very cool things in this kit that'll be talked about in part one and put together is a big drag strip display. You can have a nice display, cardboard display to set your models on. Let's take a look at this all-new decal sheet here. All redone for you with so much detail. Will be used on both kits. It's just massive. We got our stripes, number letters, sponsor call-outs, all kinds of stuff. And just look at that thing. Huge, huge decal sheet. We've got this nice AMT sticker. Go slap that right on someone's car. Don't tell them I told you to do it. And then we have this beautiful cardboard display, which will be folding up properly to display the kits. So what I'm going to do at this point is degrease the parts as always. Okay, that's a look at the beautiful box art for the 3-in-1. We got that nice Piranha race team. We're going to have everything that's on the cover in the box, including the display. I'm going to go degrease the parts for the tow car and get to working on that. We'll take a look at some of the sub-assemblies. Welcome back. We're going to go over some stuff, what I did and why I did it and stuff like that. So first up, parts we have to paint. The seats and the steering wheel. I'm going to go with a nice vinyl black on those. The upper door assembly. You can see we've got that part inside there. I cut the doors out to make sure that they would fit. The doors are operational when you are all done, but they just snap in the back there. And then you just want to assure they fit. And keep lining it up on the upper body there to make sure that there's no problems. So those will go off to the side. They will be put on some sticky tape, and then I'll be able to paint those. The wheels, I just need to dull coat them, then go in and wash in the centers so that they look a darker color. The wheels will be done. We can put the tires on. We're all set. The engine is done for the most part. It's a nice looking engine. You can see on there that 6-cylinder. Opposed engine. It's got a lot of detail on it. What I did was, you'll see that there's some parts that aren't on it. I left off the exhausts that will come out this back side of the body so that I can place it inside the chassis after painting and get it in here. I used a metal axle that I cut myself to align the rear suspension, so I made sure that I got it straight, and then the front suspension goes on and it aligns up straight as long as you assemble it per the manual. Then I glued the interior in so I could do the top of the rear suspension, get everything all set. This is just a basic interior. You'll actually have the body go over the top of almost all of it. What I'll end up doing is hand painting the footwells black, But I wanted it all in there so I could get it on there and start painting it. Now, of course, the box is yellow. My last review, yellow didn't work out well for me, but that's all right. We're going to do it again. We're going to do just fine. Don't ever be scared. This assembly here, when we're all done, will go in to those parts right there. Now, it's not going to line up perfectly at this moment. It lines up really nice, though, as you can see, into the four mounting holes to straighten it out. The windshield has a brace across it, and I'm not going to remove that until I get a chance to paint everything up. Then I'll cut that off. The interior, the body top, there's nothing in the interior. The seats will go in there, and they will paint this all body color. And then there's some decals that will go in to help us out. The hood or bonnet on the back is ready to go. That is hinged and will remain hinged like so. You can see underneath this, if you don't glue this in, this luggage rack, there's actually rifles underneath there. It's pretty cool. That's if you build the spy car. Now, I have left the seams on the additional rear storage, the hood, and the luggage area. I'm not going to sand those out and smooth them because it's supposed to look like you can actually still get in there. The hood will be able to lift up and look at the small engine in there when we're all done. The rest of the stuff is glued tight because we're just using it as panels, but it's not the spy car version, so we're not going to be needing to open those and show off any of the little cool stuff they stick in there. I also will be needing to paint the turbocharged exhausts a silver color and run those out the back of the sides of the turbos. When we get it all done, we'll put it in there. We'll glue everything into place once we get the engine in place. So it's all going together just fine. We've got the dashboard assembled. They have you cover up all the spyware on the right-hand side. They include gauges and decals on the decal sheet for these areas here, so that's going to look pretty cool. What I have to do now is get everything primered in white. Then we'll spray our yellow. Then we'll let it sit, and we'll come back, take a look at it. While the paint is drying, I'm going to throw together the cardboard diorama and get that ready to go so that when we have some paint, we can come back, we can see how that looks. I'm going to get to work. I got to put my mask on, get some primer shot, get the top coat shot, and then we'll come back, take a look how everything looks. All right, well, I've got color on the body, and this time the yellow laid down beautifully like it did last time. We won't make any mistakes this time, and I went with a little bit of a darker yellow. We can talk about that later. We're not going to touch that. It's nice and shiny, so that looks delightful, and we're just going to let that sit off to the side and dry. I assembled the cardboard display. I just love these when they include them. A little bit of shelf space. It looks great. All I have to do is tape the very bottom to get it to hold down, fold it back up. It looks great. It stands on its own. I put the tires there so you'd get a sense of scale. We'll be able to put the tow car, the trailer, and the dragster, or any other configuration. If you want them hitched together going around the corner, it goes together really nice with just some Scotch tape. They've got a nice diorama on the bottom to show you how to do it. Very, very simple. Takes maybe all of 5 minutes to get that together, and you can see the scale on there with those beautiful Goodyears. It's going to look wonderful, and it would also work as a display for other vehicles. Even though it says Piranha Drag Team, doesn't mean you can't put any other kind of cool car on there to display whenever you like. It'll hold two vehicles and a trailer. So we'll let the paint dry, we'll get some details on some stuff, we'll come back for another look. Once paint is on the body and you can actually start touching it, things go really, really quick in this build. Like I showed you, there wasn't a massive amount of parts, so stuff starts to go pretty well. We've got some things left to do. You can see that I'm letting the gull wing doors and windshield dry. I've actually glued everything together, placed the doors in, put the glass in. I've now coated everything with Future Floor Polish, not only to clear the glass up, gloss it up a little bit, but also to keep any of the super glue I used from fogging the glass and making it look goofy. So we're not going to be picking that up too much. We'll just slide it around a little bit. You can see how those doors look. You can see that they're going to still, should be able to still open when we're all done. I've still got to attach to the main body the bumper, the grill, and this yellow trim piece right there. We're not using the drag chute on this model because we have to put a hitch there instead of the drag chute. We've got the steering wheel done with just some mild chrome highlights. The dashboard is done. I've got the decals on. They're super shiny because I have decal solvent soaking into them. That's going to have to stay overnight till they all kind of get their impressions into everything. We've got the interior done. We've got the wheels and tires just loosely stuck on, so they're kind of crooked right now and uneven, but you can see how sweet those wheels and tires look. Just absolutely gorgeous. And we'll straighten those out and make sure they sit properly before we glue them permanently into place. I don't have anything spin. I did the engine in a full metallic and then washed everything in the back with the exhausts coming out and the tail light where the hitch is going to mount. What I didn't want to do was paint the block or anything. I figure on both of these builds in the entire set, I'm going to do a metallic looking engine, like something that they pull out often, tear apart, work on, and get it going. This is a twin turbo Corvair engine, so they probably have to do a lot of work on it. It's the tow vehicle, the show vehicle, same as the dragster. We're going to do all metallic engines on these as something a little different. The upper body, I've got the seats in it. I detailed the center of the seat buttons with a silver pen. Got the gas cap in. Got the grill on the rear deck lid there for the engine. And that's it. There's nothing really else to deal with on the upper body until we glue the doors and the windshield in, which will require some adjustment. We have to put some decals on the inside of the doors. Then when we glue everything together, we've got a few more decals to add, and we're all done. So it's not a lot of work right now. What I can tell you is that putting the wheel, the gullwing doors and the upper windshield together can be a little tedious, but if you hold it steady and take your time, it should go without issue. They've definitely kept up with the mold because there wasn't any warpage or any big problems. So we'll see how all that goes once we start slapping it together. Once the dashboard is dry, then all the decals are dry, then that will be glued inside the upper body. The shifter will be glued into the shift lever there, and then that will be joined to the lower body. Once that's joined and everything is rock solid, the wheels and tires are on. You can see right now it's a little wobbly because I just stuck them on there really quick, and they're still kind of half hanging off there. Once that's all glued tight, then we'll put that top on when I have a solid base to work on, and I don't have to worry about trying to line anything else up. That'll be the very last thing before the decals go on. So when I come back, we'll have a final of the Piranha tow car, and then we'll be moving on to part number two, which is the dragster and the trailer. We'll see in just a little bit. All right, and part one of the Piranha drag team from AMT is done. We've got the Piranha tow car. All right, the decal outlets are on the sides of the box. They tell you exactly how to put them on. If you're super, super careful with this assembly, and this is an advanced level kit, okay, I would not recommend this kit for a beginner. There are, so because of the gull wing doors and the opening trunk and the way the body fits together, it all fits together, but you do have to use some modeling skills to get it perfect. So when you're done, the gull wing doors will still operate. The back hood lid will still operate and see the engine back there. So you can see that. But you got to be so careful because it is such a gentle assembly. But you can push it down and get it to fit and reopen it and close it and reopen it and close it. But don't play with it a lot because those pins are less than a millimeter thick and they're just plastic. But you can get it to work. You can see inside with the steering wheel and the dashboard. You can see inside the engine there. We got those nice looking Goodyears. Just a beautiful kit. Comes out well, and I'm glad I got a yellow paint job done this time and didn't screw it up. So you can see it'll go back together. You don't want to press it in too far. You don't want to press the trunk lid down too far, or you have to use a tool from underneath to get it to pop open. So I kind of leave it sitting. I think when I display it, I'm going to glue the right door down permanently so I never break it off, and I'm going to leave this door up and glue it into place in an up position so I don't break that off as well. It's not really meant to be played with. The wheels don't turn or anything, but it's a nice looking kit. It comes out well. You can see it all the way around. It's pretty sharp. I did use one extra decal. They just have you doing the AMTs on the fenders and on the trunk lid. I put the Piranha on there, and it has logos for the other dragsters. So we're moving on to part number two, where I'll be building the trailer and the dragster. Stay tuned. Thanks for watching the workshop. There'll be a link in the description where you can get the whole Piranha Street and Strip drag team as well. See you at the next review.